Hey guys, my name is Jamie and it's been 120 days since I've been on remission from early stage breast cancer! Woot woot! So now I want to give back and share the happy news. I'm sure all of you are probably wondering, how do you treat people diagnosed with cancer without being all awkward? I have some tips to share. Tip number one, compliment. What do I mean by that? Of course, when you're going through treatment, especially chemo, you go bald, you get pale, you get weak, and we have to make an effort to look good. Syempre, parang nakakatakot lumabas kasi we feel so ugly and weak. And if we make the effort, guys, give us some compliment. Notice maybe our makeup, our nails, our headscarf, our wig, our new look. It does go a very long way. Tip number two, treat them normal. What is normal? Normal is how you would treat a normal person without diagnosed with cancer. So if you see them, say, kumusta? Ano balita? Oh, how's your parents? How's work? How's life? You don't necessarily have to always ask about cancer. You can just carry on like how you would with a normal person. We are dying to feel normal, okay? So make us feel normal. It's as simple as that. Imagine the person that you met without cancer and just treat them like how you would treat us. Ganun lang kasi simple, basic. Tip number three, be genuinely interested with a person. And when I say genuinely interested, you have to look at them in the eye and ask, so, how are you? How's everything? And from there, stop. Let them talk, pay attention, be really genuinely interested. Hindi yung tipong, kamusta? Mabuti? Ikaw? Mabuti? Come on. We deserve more than that. We've been through a lot. So we just want your time and attention. And it will make us really feel good. Tip number four. Share something interesting. Share happy stories, a joke, or good news. Guys, napakahirap ng cancer treatment. We've been through so much. So the last thing we need to hear is some negative news, some bahalin dol, politika na negative. No, we don't want to hear that. Share something fun. Para naman, we can still feel that the world is a better place. There's still hope. Give us hope by sharing happy stories. Tip number five, listen. Why? Because each cancer journey is very different from one another, which is what makes it very interesting. Let them talk because they have some interesting story to share. Tip number six, there are days when people diagnosed with cancer feel really heavy, so they want to cry and unload and share how they feel with you. And if that happens, let them. No judgment. Okay? If they cry, so what should you do? Listen. Give the poker face. Just let them unload. Huwag namang husgahan. Mahirap na yung pinagdadaanan. So when you let them unload, it helps them in so many ways. And you become a good person along the way by letting them share. Tip number seven, find ways to relate to them. And when I say relate, don't talk about people you know who died of cancer, or don't talk about other people who are sick that you know. We don't want to just be identified by being sick. Gusto namin magkwentuhan tayo about our common interests. Do you like volleyball? Oh, ask her. Hey, are you into volleyball? No, but I'm into swimming. Oh, me too. So you can talk about other things that both of you can relate to that doesn't necessarily have to be about cancer. Come on, guys, this is our life already. So we want to talk about other things. We're a person. We're not cancer. So treat us like a normal person with other interests as you do. Tip number eight, give us a hug. Come, hug Jamie. Yes, we do need a hug because it's therapeutic. It's really good. But of course, make sure to ask permission. Hey, pwede ba kita i-hug? Oh, sure, I will never say no because it's so good to be hugged and to feel loved. So go ahead, spread the love, spread the hugs. Tip number 9. If you're somewhat close to this person who's diagnosed, we really appreciate a very thoughtful gift, something more personalized or something that would be helpful in our journey, like an inspirational book or maybe perhaps a journal. Or, you know what? If you don't want to give a gift, we also appreciate a nice gesture, just giving a greeting card or a personalized letter that shares your belief in our winning over cancer. Sobrang feel na yun kasi ngayon parang wala nang sumusulat ng letters. I think it's still very much valued if you write a personalized handwritten letter. Effort yun eh. So if you receive that along with your good words and positive vibes, it feels nice. Come on, send me a letter. Send me a letter. Now. Mailbox. Tip number 10. Give us some good vibes, people. Come on. Life is good. There's hope. I know maraming nangyayari kung ano-ano sa paligid. Pero come on. Share happy thoughts to us. Tell us that you believe in us. You believe that we will win over this and we will be victorious. That's the most important thing. That's the cheapest way to show support to someone with cancer. Look at them in the eye and say, hey, you know what? You're doing good. I believe in you. You are gonna win. Yes! I'm winning and you're winning. Happy, happy, winning, winning.